Now, the Old Testament books are divided into four sections. The Torah, or Pentateuch, that means five books. The historical books, the prophets, and the writings, or wisdom literature. We'll get into all that later. The New Testament also has four sections. The Gospels, which tell the story of Jesus. The Acts of the Apostles, which talks about the early days of the church and Paul's missionary trips. The Letters, or Epistles, that's a fancy word that means, letters. And the Revelation to John, the really wild book at the back that talks about the end of the world. Any questions?
I've got a question. Why do they call them testaments? Do they give you fresh breath? Because I licked one and it didn't work.
No. They don't call them testaments. They call them testaments. Can you clue us in, Pastor Paul?
The word testament comes from the Latin word testamentum, meaning oath or covenant. A covenant and an oath are promises. So the word testament means promise.
Thanks, Pastor Paul. So the Bible is split up into two sections. One section is called the Old Promise, and the second section is called the New Promise. You know what a promise is, don't ya? It's when you make a commitment, when you say you're gonna do something, no matter what.
So who's making these big promises in the Bible, and what are they promising?
Well, let's see.
The Bible is the story of God
and what he's done for us.
So these big promises must be...
promises God has made to us.
Whoa, that's really big. Even bigger than a pony.
I think you're right.
Okay, we're on to something. This is a Bible. A Bible is a collection of books divided into two sections. Each section tells the story of a big promise God made, how he kept that promise, and most importantly, what it means to us today, how it helps us understand our world. This book has changed more lives than any other book in history, and these promises, and how they came true back then and still come true today, are the key. So, why did God have to make these promises, and what did he promise? And why should you care?
Good day, world. This is Buck Denver, and I've got news for you. The Bible! What is it? Where did it come from? What do we do with it? How does it affect our lives?
Yep, God wrote the Bible. That's why we call it God's words.
You're sort of right and sort of not. We don't call the Bible God's words, we call it God's word. And there's a difference.
Explain.
Sunday school lady?
I'll see if I can help. You see, Christians believe the Bible was inspired by God, not written by God. Pastor Paul, what does inspire mean?
The word inspire comes from a Latin word that means to breathe or blow into. It means God breathed into people the ideas or thoughts he wanted them to write about.
That's right. So God breathed these ideas into people who then wrote the different books of the Bible. God inspired them to write, and they chose the words. It's God's truth communicated through people's words.
Okay, so who were these people that God used to write the books of the Bible?
Well, since the Bible has affected so much of history, many people have debated for years and years who wrote each book. This is what most Christians believe. We believe Moses wrote the first five books. Jewish tradition says Ezra wrote 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra and Nehemiah. We think David wrote some of the Psalms, and Solomon wrote many of the Proverbs, and most likely the Song of Songs. The major and minor prophets were written, we believe, by the men those books are named for. We think Jeremiah also may have written Lamentations. In the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John were written by, well, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Luke also wrote the book of Acts, and John also wrote 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, as well as Revelation. Jesus' brother James wrote James, and the disciple Peter wrote 1st and 2nd Peter. Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus, and Philemon are all letters written by Paul, who was very, very busy. Back to you, Buck.
Hey, wait, you skipped a few books.
Oh, the other books, well, we're not entirely sure who wrote those.
Hmm? Well, How can we trust them if we don't know who wrote them?
Good question, Buck. You see, we don't trust the books of the Bible because we know exactly who wrote each one. We trust them because they're in the Bible. God not only inspired the authors who wrote these books, we also believe he inspired the process that picked which ones should be in the Bible and which ones shouldn't.